I saw this little black slick. As soon as I hit it, my car lost control.
In 2021, we met young Queensland doctor Dinesh Palipana. Years earlier, a horrific accident left him paralysed.
I was far enough in medical school to know what had happened, and I knew that I'd had spinal cord injury.
But thanks to this epic Hollywood camera rig...
Yeah, this is so cool.
...science and virtual reality, Dinesh can see and feel himself walking again.
All these cameras go off of one big hit, and then we can make really accurate 3D models of actors.
3, 2, 1, fire!
This is what Dinesh looks like in VR.
The first time I saw myself walking in one of those environments, I was just like, damn, you're handsome. It was actually just really cool. Having this avatar that recreates me, either standing or walking or cycling, wearing the clothes that I like, wearing the shoes that I like, that just feels 1,000 different kinds of good.
What do you think of the new environment?
Awesome.
But what's happening in this Gold Coast lab is so much more than a confidence-building exercise. Dinesh and his research partner, Claudio, are trying to help people walk again.
The thing is, most spinal cord injuries, they're not where the spinal cord is severed completely. So usually there's a little bit of spinal cord left, and that can reorganise, or we can strengthen the signals.
The groundbreaking technology is powered by thought.
So what we're doing is really leveraging the ability of the spinal cord to remodel, to be plastic, to re-establish those connections between the brain and the muscles, and vice versa as well.
Five participants trialled the technology for a year, and all showed improvements in muscle and bone density. 39-year-old former truck driver Heath was one of them.
The VR aspect just changes the game for me.
This is the first time Heath has visited a forest again since his accident.
I think, to be honest, in my head, I was going to walk again. Like, it was not a permanent thing.
There's still hope it isn't. Today, this helmet allows Heath to use his thoughts to enable movement in the virtual world and even control the pace of a cycle machine that's often used for training people with spinal cord injuries.
I think you just get so used to sitting still, but it quickly feels normal again. As well, like you just kind of go back, oh yeah, it's just like riding a bike.
Heath's young family is his biggest motivation.
Oh, where are these carts helping?
My family hasn't had me walking for 16 years, so I probably scare them. My walk in the door might scare them because I'm pretty tall and they're not used to me towering over them. I do think there's a future where I'll walk again. Time is always the question. It really does feel like I'm moving. I've got the environments moving past me.
The reactions have been really positive. There have been a couple of instances where, I mean, even myself have been brought to tears because of it. So it's a pretty special thing.
With the trial results already promising, Dinesh's mum has no doubt her son will make his virtual dream a reality.
I know if anyone can do it, he will crack the code and he will walk again one day.
Yeah, the ultimate goal is for me to be able to stand up on my own, to take a couple of steps. We need to be courageous because historically people have been, right? We choose to go to the moon. We choose to make a motor car. If we can just push towards that. Just one step. As it was said, it's a giant leap for mankind.
Imagine seeing yourself walk in virtual reality after all those years and being so close to maybe doing it in real life.
Yes.
What I take out of that is when he said he hadn't been back into a forest since he had his accident.
Exactly.
And so he there in virtual reality is walking in a place where he wants to walk, and that just must be such a mental stimulation for him.
What I took out of that is that Dinesh is a pretty handsome devil, according to him. but it's extraordinary. So there's five participants have taken part in the trial so far. They're looking to do a longer-term trial soon. Two participants started off with no voluntary movement at all, no sensation at all below the spinal injury, and they regained some feeling and movement by the end.
Wow.
So if that's the loop of it, right?
Yeah.
So there's the psychological bit, but if you can re-stimulate actual movement, I don't know, I'm not the first idea how that would work.
Yeah.
But that is extraordinary that they can do that, or at least that it's promising. So I hope
good people out there
fulfills its potential.